This video was inspired by the following Reddit post on creating an intercrosse stick. Before I begin, I want to state that this is not an attempt to make an actual intercrosse stick, but rather a surfacing exercise to try to emulate a similar shape and features. The surface produced here is not going to be the best. I did post this on the Autodesk forum and tried my best to implement some of the advice given. Any imperfections here are purely due to my own effort based on my own interpretation of the advice given. Please do not attribute these imperfections to the helpful folks at the forum. The intention of this video is to share the journey that I went through in creating this. I am open to suggestions on how I can improve the surface. If we look past this interlocking web and analyze the model as a whole, you can see that there is an overall shape. I will first attempt to create this overall shape by building a patchwork of surfaces. Let's first build the base. Perform a sketch on the top plane. We will make a center-to-center slot with one of the centers snapped to the origin. We want the sides to be at an angle, instead of the default vertical positions. We can delete the parallel constraint that keeps both these lines parallel. Select the parallel constraint and delete. If you find it hard to select the constraint, you can perform a long left click and select it from the drop-down menu. Create an offset plane from the top plane. On this plane, we will create a regular straight slot. With one of its centers snapped to the origin. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Loft. We will loft from this profile to this profile. Next, we will create a spline on which we can build a new surface. Begin a sketch on the right plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select this face. This will give us two lines that are a result of intersection between the sketch plane and the face. Set these to Construction. Click on Look At in the sketch palette to return to a view normal to the sketch plane. Start a control point spline. Snap one end to this point. Create another four points. And end the spline on this point. To get a good transition between the spline and the projected line, we shall make these two control handles collinear with the projected line. Control select these three lines. And click on the collinear constraint. Repeat this for the other side. Adjust the points to get the shape that you need. Do dimension the control handles to fully define the spline. For the sake of the flow of this video, I will not be defining this sketch and also many of the subsequent sketches. Let's use this spline to create a reference surface. This surface will serve as a reference for the subsequent new surface to be tangent to, so that when we mirror it across the right plane later, the transition will be smooth. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the spline and just create a thin strip. The actual distance does not matter here. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. And select the right plane as a splitting tool. The purpose of doing this is to delineate the path for the subsequent surfacing operations. One of the ways that was suggested by Peter Doering from the forum was the use of the patch command. Usually, for such a large opening, you would expect the patch command to struggle. In this case, it seems to produce a workable surface. Go to Create, Patch. Remove the Enable Chaining option. Select the edges that bound the opening. Set the continuity options as follows. Go to Inspect, Zebra Analysis, and select these two faces. You can see that the lines look pretty smooth in these two regions. There are jagged lines in these regions, which reflect tangency. This is because we started off with using arcs in our base sketch. In order to achieve curvature continuity in these regions, we will need to replace the arcs with control point splines. I will leave that to you to try. There is also a slight distortion in these areas. Overall, I still think that this is a decent enough surface for what we need. As an alternative, we will take a look at using a loft. Let's delete the patch. In my first attempt at creating the model, I tried creating a rail like so to perform a loft. I found that this creates quite an uneven surface. The problem here is that the loft profiles actually meet at a common point. So the resulting lofted surface is actually three-sided. Lofting will struggle to produce a good quality surface near this point. As a general rule, we should aim to loft to produce a four-sided surface. Again, I want to thank Peter for suggesting a creative way to create a four-sided surface in this situation. We are going to create a sketch to split out a portion of the base face in order to create another two sides. Begin a sketch on the right plane. Create two sketch lines snapped to these two points. Join these two lines with a control point spline. This sketch will be somewhat arbitrary, but do define it fully. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the sketch line as a trimming tool. And select the sections of the surface that we wish to remove. These sections will turn red. With this, we have created two extra edges to give us a four-sided opening to be patched up with a loft. Go to Create, Loft. Select this edge as a first profile. Click on the plus sign to create the next profile. Select these two edges. Fusion will combine these two edges into a single profile. For the first profile, set the continuity option to tangent and select align to surface so that it will take reference from the adjacent surface. For profile 2, set the option to curvature and set the option to align to surface so that it takes reference from the base. Click on the arrow for the rails. and select these two edges. Set both to curvature. Let's turn on zebra analysis. The lines in this region seem to look slightly cleaner compared to the patch surface, suggesting that there is less distortion. I want to thank Peter again for all these pointers. Peter was able to do a much better job than me at producing a higher quality surface. There are many nuances that I might have missed out on or misinterpreted. I would encourage you to read the thread on the forum. The link will be posted in the description. Go to the Bodies folder. Right-click on the reference surface and remove. Begin the Mirror command. Change type to Bodies. And mirror the new surface body across the right plane. Go to Modify, Stitch. And stitch all these separate surface bodies into one single surface body. We have two options to create a solid shell. We can go to Create, Thicken. Select the surface body and adjust the thickness. The thicken occurs in a direction that is normal to the surface everywhere. This will result in end faces at an angle. If this is what you are looking for, you can leave it at that. Next, delete the second step and bring back the surface body. What if you need the end face to be flat? First, go to Create, Patch. And patch up the bottom opening. Stitch these two surface bodies into one. Set the operation as new body. After you confirm, the hollow gets filled in and this becomes a solid body. Activate the solid tab. Go to Modify Shell. Select the bottom face and adjust the distance. After shelling, the bottom face remains flat. The shell command calls out the inside of the body but retains the end face. If we look at the finished model, the web design occupies a certain region. So let's define this region with a sketch and split the body. Create a sketch on the right plane. And sketch a 3-point arc. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the main body as a body to split. Select the sketch as a splitting tool. Let's rename the bodies and hide the base. The strategy that I have chosen to create these features is to create plates from the side and the front and intersect them with the web body. I've chosen to keep the web body visible so that it is easier to judge where to place the sketch lines for the plates. Create a sketch on the right plane. And create a series of lines. begin the extrude command, and select the thin extrude option. Select the open sketch lines as a profiles. Set direction as symmetric. Adjust the extrude distance to exceed that of the web body. Adjust the wall thickness and wall location. Set operation to new body so that these new extrudes do not merge with the web body. Create a sketch on the front plane. And use these sketch lines to perform a thin extrude as well. In this case, we should set the operation to join. We need to join with the previous thin extrudes, but not the web body. To do that, we simply need to hide the web body from view. If we refer to the bodies folder, we can see that all the thin extrudes have combined into one body. The web body is still separate. Go to Modify, Combine. Set the web body as a target body. Select the thin extrudes as a tool. Set operation to intersect. Since we do not need the thin extrudes after this operation, do not check on the keep tools option. After this, simply merge this body with the base using the combine command.